Hello all, in this video we are going to discuss about sample size calculation. So there are various basics about sample size calculation which we have discussed. Now in this video we are going to discuss about only the formulas required to calculate the sample size which may be asked as a probable question in undergraduate examinations. Even though the sample size calculation is not given in PARC textbook, it is good to know about sample size calculation, and also many colleges follow this sample size calculation in practicals. So we are going to deal with sample size calculation for calculation of single group mean and proportion. That will be easy and good to know for undergraduates, and for postgraduates it is good to know about the sample size calculation for two groups mean and proportions. But otherwise, for all having BCBR exams, these sample size calculation are the important area where most of the questions are asked in BCBR exams. And also these sample size calculation is essential for doing your own research. Now we move on to the topic straight away. We are going to see about four types of sample size calculations, that is for single group and for two group. Under single group we have calculation for means and calculation for proportions. That is, when we are estimating a hemoglobin in a single group, that is the example here. When we are calculating the prevalence of anemia, then it falls under this category. Under two groups, we have again the same means and proportions. Again, means, the comparison of hemoglobin between two groups, again presence of anemia between two groups. The same way we are going to deal with four formulas in this presentation. Now first is the proportion in a single group. So here, as I told, the example is prevalence of anemia among newly diagnosed lung cancer patients, the prevalence of anemia instead of hemoglobin, then it is a proportion. So here the formula is n is equal to Z alpha square P Q divided by D square. That is Z alpha square P Q divided by D square. So where Z alpha is the standard normal deviate for 95% confidence interval, the value is taken as always 1.96, and here we substitute 1.96, the square of it will become 3.84. Some people use directly 3.84 PQ by divided by D square, or some use directly 4 PQ by D square. They will round it off to the higher side and they make it as 4 PQ by D square. What is the P here is the prevalence of the anemia, or the proportion of the interest. Often it comes from the similar study or from a clinical observation or from a pilot study. So anywhere we can take this prevalence, but a previous study's prevalence need to be placed here. Then we should calculate the Q, that is 100 minus P. Q is 100 minus P. Then D is the allowable error or precision. We have two type of precision. One is absolute precision, the other one is relative precision. So absolute means, if suppose let's say the prevalence of anemia is 20%, if we are taking absolute precision of 5% means, then we directly substitute 5% here as D. Suppose let's say we are having relative precision of 5%, then we are going to substitute 5% out of this 20%, so that will become 1%. So in the place of D we should put 1%. Same way, if our absolute precision is 10%, then it is 10% of 20%, then it should be 2% in place of D. So likewise, we have to have this absolute and relative precision, but the formula is Z square PQ by D square, that is Z is alpha, or you can go with this 4 PQ by D square. That is the formula for sample size calculation of proportion in a single group. Now we work out one problem on proportion in a single group. We all should remember the formula. Here we have a question. A previous study found that the prevalence of anemia among newly diagnosed lung cancer patient is 60%. So in your mind, you should work out that P will be 60 and Q will be 100 minus 60, that is 40. So we already have this value of P is 60 and Q is 40. Then allowable error, D, depends upon the researcher's need. Usually it should not exceed 20% of the P. Therefore, in this case, D can be a maximum value of 12, that is 20% of 60 will be 12. So we substitute 12 as D here. So the sample size, when we calculate, it will be 3.84 into P is 60, Q is 40, divided by 12 into 12, because D is 12, so D square. So when we work out, we get the sample size of 65. So that is what we have got here. So this is the problem of single group proportion. Next, we move on to the sample size calculation for mean of a single group. So now here, as an example, the mean hemoglobin among lung cancer patients, the formula will be sample size is equal to Z square alpha. Instead of PQ, we have standard deviation square divided by D square. So the formula remains same except for this standard deviation. So instead of PQ, we are using standard deviation square. Again, we are describing the formula as same as previously. Z alpha is standard normal deviate. For 95% confidence interval, the value will be 1.96. Again, Z square will be 3.84. We all remember that. Then standard deviation, it often comes from the similar study or clinical observation or from a pilot study. Suppose if we don't get standard deviation from a previous study, then we can go for the formula range divided by 6. If we get range from previous study, then we can divide the range by 6 and we can approximately get the standard deviation. So that's how we can take up the standard deviation. And D is the allowable error, also called as precision. As we told, it is again divided into absolute and relative precision, and it is calculated by reliability coefficient into standard deviation. That's a formula, separate formula. You need not go with this, but we can have an allowable error based on the variability. Now we are going to work out a problem here. Suppose a previous study mentioned that the mean hemoglobin for the newly diagnosed lung cancer patient was 9. So here the mean is 9 with a standard deviation of 2. So the sample size, how are we going to calculate this? The n is 3.84 into standard deviation square, that is 2 into 2, divided by 0.5 we are taking as a precision, that is allowable error. We are taking it as 0.5. So we get a value of 62. So in order to get the correct mean of a single group with the precision of 0.5, with the standard deviation of 2, you have to study 62 samples in your study. So that is how we calculate the sample size calculation for a mean of a single group. Next, we move on to the sample size calculation of difference in proportion between two groups. So here is an example, the prevalence of anemia between lung cancer patients and bladder cancer patients. So here the formula you need to remember, the same formula for the proportion was Z equal to Z alpha square PQ by D square. That was the formula for single group proportion. Now we are dealing with the two group proportion. Instead of that PQ, we have this P1Q1. We have this P1Q1 plus P2Q2 divided by D square. We have Z alpha square. Sometimes we incorporate Z beta also in the formula. If suppose the beta is important, that is false positives are important means, then we need to consider Z beta also, and the formula will be added by Z beta. But commonly Z beta will not be included. Only Z alpha will be there in that formula. So here where Z alpha is same, Z value for level 1.96, 95% confidence interval, the value is 1.96. Z beta is Z value for beta level. It is 0.84 for 80% power. and 1.28 for 90% power. So that is, here we take 95% of alpha level. Here it is rejection of the truth. So this is more serious. So we allow only up to 95%, but for accepting the false is the beta error. So that is less serious and less dangerous. So we allow up to 90% or sometimes more commonly 80%. So for this, the level will be 1.28 for 90% power and 0.84 for 80% power. So if we also have to take that also into consideration, but here most commonly we are not applying that Z beta, but P1 is the proportion in the first group, that is here anemia among the lung cancer patients, and Q1 will be 100 minus P1. P2 will be proportion of the second group, that is here anemia among the bladder cancer patients. Q2 will be 100 minus P2, and D is allowable error. Here the allowable error is the clinically meaningful difference, that is the difference between two groups in the previous study. So let us work out one problem on this and we understand sample size calculation of proportion between two groups. Now we have kept the formula here. Now the question is, what is the difference in proportion of anemia between lung cancer patients and bladder cancer patients? So from previous studies, the researchers found that proportion of anemia could be 40% and 60% in the two groups respectively. So how many samples are needed in each group to detect a clinically meaningful difference with a precision of 4% points? Here Z is equal to 1.96. So we are substituting that, and P1 for this formula, we have 40 here and Q1 will be 60, and for P2, it will be the reverse. So 60 here and 40 here. So P1 minus P2 is 20. So this is the clinically meaningful or expected difference between two groups. So D here is 4%, that is 20% of P1 minus P2. Therefore, when we are applying this formula here, we have this Z square, that is 3.84 into P1 Q1, that is 60 into 40 plus 60 into 40 divided by 16. When we work out, it will yield 1152 patients in each arm, that is in each group. So that is how we calculate sample size for difference in proportion between two groups. Next, we move on to the sample size calculation for means between the two groups. So here the example is, what is the mean hemoglobin level between lung cancer patients and bladder cancer patients? So where Z alpha is Z value for alpha level, that is 1.96 for 95% confidence interval, and standard deviation SD here is the pooled variance. Here the formula is N1 minus 1 into standard deviation 1 square plus N2 minus 1 into standard deviation 2 square divided by N1 plus N2 minus 2. And D is the allowable error, also called as precision. Here we are working out a problem. So the researcher found that the mean hemoglobin for lung cancer patient was 11. Standard deviation was 1.5 based on 35 patients and 6 gram per deciliter. Standard deviation of 2 for bladder cancer patients based on 55 patients. How many patients does the researcher need in each group if she wishes to estimate the clinically meaningful difference with a precision that is within 20% of the true difference with 95% confidence? So the pooled variance SD square is, here for the pooled variance, this is the SD or the pooled variance. So for that, we need to substitute the N1 minus 1, that is, this is N1, this is standard deviation 1, this is standard deviation 2, this is N2. So if we substitute the formula, here it will be like this, N1, N2 will be there. So we get a pooled variance as 3.75. When we again substitute here the pooled variance, we need to calculate the mean 1 minus mean 2, that is the mean difference. So we need to identify the clinically meaningful or expected difference between the two groups. So again, D is the 20% of the difference. We have got the difference as 5. So 20% of 5 means 1 gram per deciliter. So if we substitute the values, that is 3.84 into the standard deviation square, that is Here, let us put variance 3.75 into 3.75 divided by d square, that is 20% of 5, that is 1 into 1. So if we do the calculation, we get approximately 15 per group. So both group, we need to take 15 individuals in order to identify the difference in mean between two groups. So this is the formula. It looks like the same formula, but the standard deviation here is the pooled variance from the formula which we need to calculate. So to sum up, in this video we have seen about sample size calculation of means proportions for single group and two groups. For the single group mean, the formula is z square sigma square, that is standard deviation square, divided by d square, where single group proportion, the formula is z square pq by d square. Same way, we have the modifications for two groups, the five dealt in detail. Here in the background, you can see the formula for mean difference between two groups. Hopefully, this video was useful to you and you are clear about sample size calculations for single two group mean and proportion. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please subscribe and share this video to your friends. Thanks for watching.